You don't have to peel on anything. Just put it straight on your pot.
Okay.
Just take the top. I just took the top out, and then I'm just gonna put in there.
It's kind of dirty.
You can wash them. Mine is pretty clean. Okay, maybe you can hear, see me better. That's perfect. Put a little pinch of salt in the water, just so your beet has, just to enhance the flavor of the beet. Just a very little pinch. And then let me know when you're ready, because we're going to pass it on to the spaghetti squash.
Okay, they're in. And it's as big as I got.
Yeah, mine is pretty big, too.
I know. Okay, this is awesome.
Okay, ready? So what I'm going to do... Those are never, can be tricky to open. I'm just going to put the tip of my knife in the middle and then go through into the other side. And then I'm going to push it away. Make sure that you're doing this away from your body. You know, like don't do like this because you might slip and you might end up cutting yourself. Make sure it's away from your body. And then I have this. And we gotta take the seeds off.
I'm still working on it.
Yeah, they're very hard. It happens.
Honey.
It does happen.
I need my knife not sharp enough.
Oh, but it's some butternuts, some spaghetti squash are very hard because they might like not be fully ripe. This one I have here like on my house for almost a week because I bought it. I learned that whenever I go to the market, I gotta buy fruit and my vegetables for the next week. So I give a week for them to finish to ripe in my house before I actually eat them.
That's a good idea.
So easy to cut with a smaller one, you know.
Yeah, honey, I don't have your muscle.
Good.
That's good. You guys cooking together?
Yeah. Yeah.
Sort of, but
he just sweeps up the floor and picks up the trash and cuts things that I can't.
That's good. It's called teamwork. Yeah. One cook, the other one does the dish and take the trash out.
Yeah, that's him. Or he gets it ready for the dishwasher.
Yeah, that's the best.
Okay, and then just dig them out.
Okay, so we got it.
You're gone again.
Okay, so now he's back on. So with the spoon, you're just gonna scrape the seeds off. Just in the middle, like this. Okay, let me know when you're done. You done?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So on a tray, on a baking tray, I'm just gonna put some aluminum foil because I always find easier to do it. Then they're easier to clean. And then you can put your spaghetti squash on there. And all you have to do is just put some a little salt and pepper and olive oil. You don't need to put a lot because we're going to season later on. Okay. So I'm just putting black pepper and then some salt. And then you put, I'm just going to put a very little drizzle of olive oil in the middle. You can use your hands or you can use like a brush, whatever you want, but you gotta just does like just spread the olive oil all around.
Okay.
And then once you had done that, once like you spread olive oil all around, just flip them upside down.
<Not anymore.
laughs> Yeah, that. And here. And once you flip upside down, just put in the oven. Let me wash my hands.
Middle shelf? Middle shelf?
Just fine. Are you gonna use cheese for the salad?
No.
Oh no, you're not eating cheese. Are you not gonna use pine nuts as well?
No.
Okay. So I'm just gonna get some sage outside in the garden and I'm gonna start to chop the onions and everything ready for the spaghetti squash.
Okay, I'm gonna pick my sage from the garden.
Okay.
Brazil originally. Yeah.
Oh, we gotta roast our tomatoes. Let's put the tomatoes first.
Okay.
We gotta put the tomatoes first because they're gonna take a little bit of time.
Yeah, I noticed it said and I was like, well, how do we do that? I have yellow ones. I didn't have
you got the yellow ones?
Yeah.
So all you have to do, cut them in half lengthways so you have them like this.
Okay.
And just, you can cut the whole, I think you can cut the whole box, or maybe half box, that'll be good enough.
I'll probably just do it.
I don't know how big is your box, how many tomatoes you have in there.
But well, mine is very big. I have a lot of tomatoes, so I'm just going to use halves.
Okay. I had two boxes, but I ate one well.
The yellow ones are very sweet and they're delicious.
Yeah. I was like, whoops, I'm getting ingredients.
No, they're good. They're actually a very good snack.
Yeah, I've never broken them, so this would be nice.
I like them. I like summer is coming up, and then you're going to have the tomatoes that's going to be in season, the berries going to be back in season.
Yes. I get a box from a local organic farmer every week.
Yeah.
So lots of fresh veggies and herbs.
Oh, what's the company you get your vegetables delivered from?
Oh, they don't. I have to pick them up. I live in a very rural area, but it's called All Seasons Farm.
Oh, you gotta go to pick them up.
I go to our local co-op store to pick them up.
Oh, you gotta share me the information because I'm always looking for things like this.
Okay.
Yeah, because I'm always looking for farm like. Direct okay. From the farmers. I'm always looking for something like this.
Okay, I definitely will.
Yeah, just send me my message because then I will check them out. Once you finish to slice your tomatoes, just put a little drizzle of olive oil. I'm gonna put salt and pepper again, and I'm also gonna put some dry oregano. If you have at home, you can use it. You can use dry basil, whatever you have at home, whatever you like it. But I like oregano. They don't take long in the oven. Okay. So they're going to be there for 10 minutes max, but 5-10 minutes. Mix them. You gotta mix them to make sure the season is well.
I ran out of foil. Well, I got parchment paper. Will it work on parchment paper?
So what did you just ask?
I'm out of foil. Will parchment paper work?
Yes. You can put straight in your baking tray. It's not a big deal. I just put foil because then it's easier to clean the tray, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's the only reason. So you can put straight in the tray. You know, when they're seasoned like this, just olive oil, salt and pepper, and oregano, I can eat a whole bag of this, a whole package. They're so good.
I had pots and pans and I never used them. I used them all. Mm. All right, so... Yeah. Now I'm putting on salt and pepper, correct?
Yes, a little bit of salt and pepper, a little bit of dry oregano if you have, or dry basil. You can also use, I think, those two. And then you put in the oven.
And these are for 400 as well?
Yeah, just put in the same amount. We're just going to leave them there very shortly. It's going to take like 5-10 minutes max, and we're gonna take them out.
Do I need to Do they need all
You need what,
them?
Sorry?
Do I need to mix them up with my hands?
Yeah, mix them up with your hands or your spoon, whatever you feel the best.
And how about, do you put olive oil on them or just the spices?
I'll put a little bit of olive oil as well.
I love your accent.
Oh, thank you. Oh, so you asked me how I pronounce my name. It's Alini.
Alini, okay.
Yes.
I like that.
So nice. Thank you. I'm so happy that you guys kept on your diet after the Tony Robbins seminar.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Yeah, it was something I was looking for more clarification on anyway. And so me and him just went to Palm Beach. He hadn't been.
How was it?
It was wonderful. It was amazing. It was great.
Oh, I love it. I wanted to go so bad. I was so upset that I couldn't go.
Yeah. I was supposed to take my mom. She got sick. She was going to go with us. It was better she got sick before than got here because it would have been a rough ride home.
Yes.
So hopefully we're going to Dallas.
Are you guys going to Dallas? When is going to be Dallas?
Dallas is June 23rd.
Okay.
And I'm going to take my mama. So are you thinking about going?
I don't think I'll be going to Dallas, but I'm hoping he comes back to LA this year so I could go, or another place.
In San Jose in
Sorry?
October?
You think they'll be? I heard they're going to be in San Jose in October. So I'm debating to go. I'm going to see what's going to happen.
My daughter's getting married in October.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. So I don't, or in, yeah, October. So I don't know if I'll make it.
Oh, nice.
According to the work situation is. So.
Yeah.
But she's getting married.
Yeah, no.
That'll be the next week.
So my beach is almost ready.
Okay.
I'm just gonna dice the onions and the garlic and the sage just to leave ready on site. We can put in a little bowl. I'm gonna get a little bowl, and we can just put it in there.
How do you know if they're ready?
I stick my knife into it, and once your knife falls out, it's because they're ready. So mine is not totally falling out, but it's taking a while, but eventually they will fall out.
Yeah, mine's
going to be somewhere near. Yeah, I think by the time we finish to do the rest, all the onions might be done. Okay, so I have a half onion here, and I'm not going to use more than half onion. You can use a whole onion if you want, if it's small, but this one is really big, so I'm just going to use halves. Mine was just huge.
Yep, I have a big one as well.
Yeah, so just use half, might be better. Okay, let me know when you're ready because I wanted to show you how we cut the onion, like how we chef cut the onions.
Okay.
All right, so you have half of them on there, and usually keep the root because there is one side that they have the root and some side, another side you had the head. So whatever you cut the roots, that is what you keep on the back, and then the heads you keep on the front, and then you're gonna do like this. You're gonna come with your knife, and then just gonna hold it, and just you're gonna cut it this way, you see, but you don't cut all the way through it. And you're gonna do this 4 times because this onion is too big. So you're gonna do this 4 times. So they still hold it together. I slice them in the middle, but they still hold it together. And now that I did this, I'm just gonna go different way. So I had my onion this way. Now I'm just gonna flip this way. And then I'm gonna go with the tip of my knife and I'm just gonna slice them again. Make little cuts. Just put the tip of your knife in there and just run the rest of your knife. Just push it down. Because this way, whenever you finish, you have already diced onion.
Oh.
Yeah, it's the easiest way. They should teach everyone. So once you do this, you're just going to have to cut your knife. You're just going to have to slice them. Just go through. And then they already dice. And if you want very small dice, you just cut them very thin, and then you're gonna have very thin dice. And then if you want a bigger, you just cut it bigger. I don't know if I made myself explain well. I don't know if you could understand me. Okay, good.
Yeah, I get it. Sure.
For this one, I like to have them very small, you know, very thin slice, very thin dice. And the end, you can just slice it and just go over and just chop over like how I am doing now. Okay. Or if you want, you can just throw them off, you know, like use for something else. If you cook every day, if you're just going to do something that you can use big onions or like soup, you can use for something else.
Yeah, I cook all the time from scratch now.
Oh, that's awesome. It's the best thing. And the good thing is like even if you get busy again, like if for some reason your life changed and you change job or whatever, and you start to get very busy, you're always going to make a time for cooking for yourself because that's going to become your priority. Because you realize how much better is your food and how you feel after eating is much better than after eating outside in the restaurant, which is very heavy food.
Yes.
How you feel after eating is a very good way to see if that food was good for you or not good for you, you know?
Oh, yeah.
I'm crying. You got it?
I think I've almost got it. I'm kind of crying a little bit, but...
Oh, yeah. I am crying, too. Don't worry. But it's all good at the end. Sometimes you cry in the middle, but it's all good at the end.
When you cry in the middle.
It's so sad.
Yeah, so sad. Food.
So sad.
Okay, what did you put in your onion?
I just put in a little ball like this on side. And now I'm just going to chop the garlic, put in there, and I'm going to chop... Just like do a chiffon out of my sage, and then I put in there as well. So get 3 cloves of garlic.
All right. I cheat on cutting garlic.
Sorry?
I cheat on cutting garlic. I put it in here.
It's okay. We can cheat. Whatever makes easier. Okay, so I have to catch up because if you cheat, yours already cut it.
No, I haven't cut it yet.
Okay.
I was like, I don't know, should I tell? Should I not?
No, you can't tell. I don't mind. You can, if you have like a garlic mince, you know those garlics that you just squeeze and they already cut off?
Yeah.
You can use those ones too. I use them very often.
They, I haven't found one yet that was a very good one, you know, where it's tear up or something.
Yeah, I actually, you're right. They are very hard to find good ones. I have one, they're not very good. One client of mine shares one that's awesome, it's amazing, but I don't know where she bought it.
Mm-hmm.
I need to find out. Once I find out, I'll let you know.
Wonderful.
Oh, these onions make me cry so much. I'm crying.
It's the soul.
Oh. I'm so happy that you're cooking the recipes from my book. I love it.
Oh, I love them.
Oh, it's so good.
They are.
It gets me excited. Eventually, one day I wanted to write another book, mm-hmm. but it makes me excited to know that you are doing the recipes and that you enjoy. That actually it helps me to use it as a drive to write one other book one day.
And that's what I'm going to put in the video. You have given me the confidence to cook because that was great. It didn't turn out right, and I didn't have good, or I don't know, I think it was just all about my belief. And
yes.
So you give me the confidence to cook, and I had so much fun the last time. And
oh, that's so nice.
Yeah, it was all those ladies, it was a blast.
Oh, that's so good. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. It makes me very happy when I hear something like this. Because for me, cooking is so simple. It's just like, yeah, that's what I do. It's so simple. But more I'm cooking and more I'm talking with different people, I understand, like, I'm seeing the difficulties. And whenever I see they overcoming the difficulties and just changing their lifestyle, it just makes me so happy. It's like, okay, if I die now, I succeed something in my life, you know?
Aww.
Yeah, it makes me so happy. You have no idea. So I got all my sage. I got all my leaves of my sage. So what I did, I just stuck them all on the top of each other. I make a little like okay. This. I just got my leaves. You take the stalk out, you don't want the stalk, and just mm-hmm. stack them on one of the top of each other. Because that's gonna make it easier for you to do a chiffonade on them.
Okay. What?
You pretty much just slicing. They just give a good name. They just make a fancy name for just say you're going to slice them.
Okay. So they're all
that. Yeah, just put all the top and just slice them as thin as you can do it.
Yeah, your recipes are so easy to follow in a book.
Yeah.
Super easy. And I've made food with them. My sister-in-law is from Pakistan.
Yeah.
And she tries to eat food.
Sorry.
Oh. I lost you.
I'm nunca vai te dizer não pra ir lá fora, pode ter certeza. Okay, what did you do for your sister-in-law? You said she's from Pakistan and you did something, I couldn't hear you.
Okay, she tried to teach me to cook chicken curry. Butter chicken?
Yeah. Yes!
It did not turn out well.
No? That's not good.
Eat any of it.
Oh, that's not good. Did you do it chicken? Maybe it was the chicken.
It wasn't. It was, I don't know, it was cooking like tomatoes and everything, like,
I'm going to do one class with a curry one day, because then I can help you out. Oh, we got to take our tomatoes out of the oven, and I am turning off my beets as well, because they're ready, and now we're just going to wait for the butternut squash. Not the butternut squash, the spaghetti squash. It's like, what? I didn't get this shopping list.
No, actually, I have one of those. But it's not what I put in the oven.
Oh, yeah. I actually love butternut squash. It's one of my favorite squash.
He loves it, too. Do I put the sage in the garlic in with the onions?
Yes. How many leaves of sage do you do?
I did like probably 7.
Yeah, that's perfect. That's a good amount. Okay, so strain your beets.
Okay.
And then if you run under cold water, I want to try to show you. Let me just see. This is really hot. But let me just try. Okay. So we didn't peel it. And then, can you see me?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you just do like this, if you just push with your hand, so with your fingers, will come off. All the skin will come off. So it's easier this way. Oh, but do it under running cold water because they are very hot. Oh, that's weird. No, this. Okay, it's gone. It's a very weird noise.
Vibrates the whole day.
Yeah.
It's a little weird.
I enjoyed this class so much because I was cooking for myself as well. And then I always find boring sometimes because I'm here in the kitchen by myself. And then whenever whatever there is someone else with me, like on the other side, it's just like, yeah, what did you do? How was your day? And what's going on with your life? And then the cooking just goes way faster.
Yes, it does. It does make it more fun. I said one of these days I'm going to have one of my daughters that live close to me. I said she's going to come and we're going to do it together.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, so we can do your class together.
That's awesome.
I have to ask her what she wants to cook, and then I'll tell you.
Okay, perfect. That makes it easier for me.
Yeah, we'll sign up for sure.
Yeah, because all the menus that I have been doing in the class is always related with someone else asking me. Like, I have a client of mine. She loves this spaghetti squash dish that we're going to do it today. She loves it. It's one of her favorites. So then I did it in the class because of that, because someone told me that dish they love, and I just like, okay, I teach a class on this.
Yeah. Okay. That's awesome. So you have personal clients that you work with?
Yes.
Awesome.
Okay, that peel. Is yours peeler as well?
Oh yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. So perfect. So now we're gonna slice it. Yeah, that's the best, huh? Because to peel before, it's, those ones are golden, the yellow ones, so that's fine. But the purple ones, once you peel them, you get your hands all purple. So this way you just put it in there and they come off so easy. You don't get your hands dirty.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so now I'm gonna slice it. Try to slice as thin as you can find, you know, something like this.
Not bad. It's thin on one side, it's thick on the other.
Yeah, that happens. It happens with me too sometimes, so don't worry.
If it looks like I need a knot. Oops, a flat end.
You can do it. They have like a mandoline, you know, like a slicer. You can do this on the slicer as well.
I don't like, well, I've not gotten a hold of a good mandoline. It seems like they are to use.
Some are very easy. I don't know. I think it's just habit because I'm so used to use them.
Yeah.
You just need to find a place to sharp the blades after, because nothing keeps sharp forever. So sometimes they just become harder just because the blades are just turned blind. Okay, I finished one.
So what happened to all the ladies on the first one?
Okay, so this week, there is a bunch of friends of mine. This week we call the Azusa Fest. I think Azusa Now is like a big thing that's going on in downtown. And they're all pretty much busy and entertained with that. So they all did. And some of people that actually wanted to do their way as well, because they like the kids on the spring break, so they went for the spring break.
Yeah.
And one woman that she actually joined the class and everything, but for some reason she couldn't make the class, so she just asked me to record so she can see it later and do it later.
Awesome.
Yeah, this is awesome because with the recording, like, people can see it later. Because not the time doesn't work for everyone sometimes, but right. If they still want it, they can see it later.
Yep, so the next one I'll do live, the next time we do one, I'll do a live video on Facebook. We'll figure out, because I need you on the
Yeah. Computer. I don't know, my computer is weird. Sometimes it works just fine. Last class I did, it worked just fine. And then just was one woman that I couldn't hear her, but everyone else was fine. And now my computer is not working. So I don't understand technology much.
Well, yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
I'm not sure why.
Yeah, me neither. I don't understand, because if it never worked, it's okay, but sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't, so I just don't understand what's going on. So to go on with our salads, I'm just going to put in a bowl like some arugula.
Okay.
I have a box, so I'm going to put like half of the box of the arugula. Are you not going to put pine nuts?
No.
Okay. You don't like... Really?
Yeah, I end up with eczema.
Oh, wow. You probably have some sort of allergy or something.
Yeah, it's like, that's great. I love nuts, but can't eat them.
Mm.
Avoid them.
That's okay. And then I just put my pine nuts, and I'm just gonna mix my tomatoes in there as well.
Pine nuts, didn't you?
No? Sorry?
Did you roast your pine nuts?
Oh, I actually didn't. Not just once. I know sometimes it's better when you roast them. Uh-huh. But I like when they're raw as well. I really like them than when they're raw. Because when they roast, it's just... I don't know, the oil for some reason just change. And I know mm-hmm. it's become crunchy and everything, but I like when they're not roasted. I just love the flavor. I think the sweeter when they're not roasty. Mm. And the oil is just there, you know, like the whole oil is there, is not changing. Because whenever you heat up the oil, it changes the flavors and the textures. Not the texture, sorry. It changes the flavors. Like oil for oil, when you drink it on a salad, is really good. When you put it in your food, it tastes a little bit different. So mm-hmm. pine nuts is one nut that I like raw. Like almond, I rather to have almonds raw than I have to have them roast. But cashews, I cannot eat cashews raw. I like them roast. No, so each nut is different. Yeah.
I like almonds, hazelnuts, pecans, walnuts.
In Ayurveda, we always say that it's a good idea to roast the nuts because it helps with the digestion, because it helps break down the fat, the cooking, everything. And then especially some nuts raw, they might have some bacteria, they might have some bugs, so it's always a good idea to roast them. We say in Ayurveda, but sometimes I just like them raw. Yeah. It's okay.
I tried them roasted too, and they still can't eat them.
Yeah. Okay. If you can put your beets in your salad as well.
Okay.
So I'm not going to put the cheese, because you're not going to put the cheese neither, and I don't like to eat the cheese very much as well.
Yeah. I'm still doing the... See, we're doing the... We're 3 weeks post Tony Robbins, so we both did the alkaline eating for 3 weeks.
It's awesome.
So we got the food.
It's awesome because you never go back again. As soon as, if you, for some reason, because I have done this, I used to be very healthy, very clean. And then whenever I moved here at the beginning, I had a difficulty to adjust with everything. And I started to cook a lot for my private clients, and then I didn't feel like coming home and cook again, so I started to eat it out. It didn't take long. I started to feel so shitty, like so sick. I had nausea all the time. I'm like, all the time. And then I just realized it's the food, and then I'm back eating health again. You're never going to be able to eat unhealthy food without having a headache. Sorry to let you know, but this actually is a good news.
I know, it's like, because I did on Easter, I ate a little bit, and I didn't feel good, and I didn't feel energetic, and, you know, the next day, so it was like, okay,
yeah.
That's fine, if I'm going to eat something, well, I'm going to make it myself, because you're awesome recipe. But,
yeah, no, and it's just so much better when you make your own food.
Yeah. And then I'm also going to go to, we've got a vegetarian restaurant in town, and they make things, they have their own bakery.
Oh, so, that's good.
These tomatoes are amazing.
Oh, they're very, so whenever you mix in the salad, just be careful because they're very, very soft. And you don't want them to break, and just the juice is just going to squash them all over. So just be careful. Just toss slightly, as slightly you can toss. So you don't need to worry about this much. Mm-hmm. And then you can just put it on the side. But I don't think...
Our butternut squash is ready yet. Let me just check. We gotta leave a little bit longer. Okay. Let me just wash my hands.
So it's going to cook like an hour, doesn't it?
They take 40 minutes to an hour, something like this, to cook. But mine, they're almost done. I think I'm just going to leave another 10 minutes, and I'm just going to take them out, maybe another 5 minutes. So if you have a frying pan, and then we can start to do the onions, because then we can slow cook them.
I'm licking my pan, unicorn.
What? Sorry?
I'm licking the pan that's made of green.
Yeah, those are very good. I love tomatoes like this. Roasted with just olive oil, some oregano is the best. Okay. I'm going to use olive oil. You can use... Do you know about this butter? That's what I wanted to show you. Do you know this one?
No.
Because it's a vegan butter. They still... Sorry? It has what?
Soy.
No, I couldn't understand. It's breaking in a little bit.
Soy?
No, it doesn't have whey on it because it's a vegan butter. So it's not a margarine. The only difference between this is a margarine is because this one use sunflower lecithin to set so they can have the butter consistency. And the margarine, they just heat up the oil, like they beat up the oil, they beat up, they keep beat up, and then it turn to the oil end up just naturally turn into trans fat, and that's the margarine. This one, they don't turn to trans fat just because they have this lecithin. And lecithin is the emulsifier. It's just something that's makes harder and join things together. So that's why I like this vegan butter. But they still have palm oil, and palm oil is not very good. So I use sometimes when I gotta use butter, but I don't use like often, like to put on my toast or anything like this.
So do is sesame seed oil okay to cook with?
Sesame seed oil is more like seasoning. You know, you don't. You can heat up to high smoking point sesame seed oil, but it's not. I don't use much for cooking. I use more for flavoring at the end, like a drizzle at the end. It's like truffle oil. You know, it's just used for seasoning at the end.
Okay.
But you can use sesame seed oil for cooking because they have the dark sesame seed oil and they have the light one. The light one has less flavor, not very strong. So maybe you can use it. Okay, so I'm gonna put this butter on the pan. And I'm also gonna put a little bit of olive oil because whenever you mix, you put butter on the pan, if you don't put olive oil, they're gonna burn it. I don't know, are you using olive oil only or what are you using?
Yeah, I'll just use olive oil.
Okay, perfect. And then have your fry pan like low to medium. And then we can put everything else, all garlic, onions, and the sage as well. Mm-hmm.
They smell so good. I don't know how you're doing over there, but the smell of the onion, garlic, and sage all together is so delicious.
It's going to smell like Thanksgiving.
Yes, because you guys use a lot of sage on Thanksgiving, that's true.
To make the stuffing.
Yeah. I do this. I love Thanksgiving food. I love very much. And I wait the whole year for each Thanksgiving food. So in the middle of the year, I just do a Thanksgiving pie. So I get some ground turkey. I know you're probably not eating turkey, but I just do some ground turkey. And I mix the ground turkey with green beans. And then I put the green beans, and then I make like a sweet potato mash, like a yam mash. And I mix the yam mash, and then I put on the top of the turkey with the beans. And then I put some pecan as well in the mash. So I have everything that I love for Thanksgiving in one pie, in one dish. And I just love it. Let me know how you're doing over there. I think the spaghetti squash is ready to come out of the oven.
Yeah,
my sister is still heating up very slowly. Let me know how is yours. Gonna be very hot too. Oh yeah, those are good.
My spaghetti squash turned out wonderfully.
Oh, perfect.
Are you using fork? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, that's what I'm using fork. So I just took my garlic onion out of the stove just because I don't want them to burn. Okay. I'm just going to take them out while I'm doing this. I flip my spaghetti squash over so I have them up, they're facing up. And then I'm just going to go with the fork and just turning to them into spaghetti, just like scrape the spaghetti.
I've never made it before.
I love how you make your spaghetti squash normally.
I usually cut the ends off and cut it in half, get out all the seeds, put a little bit of water in the pan, and then flip it upside down and cook it.
Ah, same, just a little bit different. I guess if you put salt at the beginning, as we did, it just helps with the flavor, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is perfect. Because they're not like overcooked. Sometimes I overcook them and I don't like when I do that. And this one is just perfect.
Made my grandson about throw up.
Yeah? When you overcook them, they just become so mushy. It's just, oh.
Yeah, he about threw up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Such a
good boy.
I tried to poison them. He never probably is going to eat spaghetti squash again in his life.
Yeah, he probably will. Well, he was three, so.
Oh, yeah, so he probably will. He has time. He will, yeah. He will overcome that. Oh, it's awesome. Okay, so I am done here. I got most of out, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I did a good job. And then I'm going to put on my frying pan. But that's going to be tricky, so you got to be very careful. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use my tea towel and put my spaghetti squash on my tea towel. Because if you put it in your hands, you're just going to burn yourself. So I put it.
I'm just putting the garlic in.
Okay. So I'm just going to wait so we are together. Did you put your onion and everything together or you put in things separately?
No, I put it all in together now.
Okay.
First, and now I'm adding the garlic.
Okay, perfect. So just give them don't let them to change color. You want them to cook and become soft, but translucent. You don't want them to change color. That's why I say like have low to medium heat. Don't have like a medium heat because they'll change colors. Yeah, they smell good. Smell really good here.
Yeah, I think my husband's liking the smell. He's working out right now.
He's working out?
Yeah, he's doing workout.
He's going to be hungry.
Yes, he will.
That's good.
Yeah. Oh, he was so hot.
I'm so happy with the change of life you guys are making.
Oh, yeah. Me too.
So how did he go on the Tony Robbins? Did he walk on fire?
He did not. He was kind of in and out a lot, but stayed. Made a big difference. Made a big difference in our relationship. Yeah.
But that's awesome. That's awesome.
Yeah, it did. It made a huge difference.
Oh, it's so.
And that helps him learn to be a better husband.
That's awesome. Like once you whatever helps you to become a better person, you just will become a better husband, better friend, better worker. Whatever you're doing, you just become better at it.
Yes. Have you done any of the other Tony Robbins events?
No. I really wanted to do the university. I love that man. I just love him a lot.
Yeah, he's amazing.
He's really good. He's amazing. I really like him.
Yeah, you can do the Master Union.
Yeah. I wanted to do it. Did you do it the date of the destiny?
Yeah. Next time, we're going to go together.
Oh, how was it? It was good?
It was worth 10,000 times what I paid for it.
Oh, that's awesome.
It made the biggest change in me.
That's so good. So happy.
Yeah, and so with their spouses.
So now your husband's gonna go with you to the date with the destiny.
Yeah.
Oh, how awesome! I'm super excited for you guys.
I don't know when we'll get to. I hope we get to. Wedding. I'm sure. It's kind of busy.
Yeah.
He's getting married in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
Who is getting married?
My youngest daughter.
Oh, yeah, you told me.
Yeah, they're getting married in Nashville, Tennessee. We rented a mansion.
Wow, that's going to be good.
Yeah, and so she's going to have a tent. There's only going to be like 55 people there. So she wants to do, for the reception, she's going to do, she's going to have like sweets, some sweets first, and then she's going to do a taco bar.
Oh, that's awesome. I am doing the same thing. A friend of mine, she just asked me to do her wedding. She wants to do just vegan tacos and vegan burgers, and that's what I'm doing. And she's doing like a pool party as a wedding. I found it was a great idea.
Yeah. And then she's doing like three courses, like do the sweets and then do the taco bar, and then she's doing steak and shrimp.
That's awesome. So my onion garlic, they're good. They fry. I threw them out of the stove. And I scrape my spaghetti squashy on here.
Okay.
Are you with me or where are you?
Yeah, I'm getting ready to put it in the pan.
Okay, perfect. And then once you put it in the pan, just add a little bit more salt. Just get a good pinch of salt and then some more black pepper. Okay, then I'm gonna put back on the stove. And then I'm gonna mix with the fork, with the same fork, because I'm always scared to use something else and start to break the spaghetti squash and then just become a blob. So I use the fork so they keep, like, as a spaghetti, the same consistency.
You said more salt and pepper?
Yeah, I put more salt and pepper. And then I put back on the stove, and now I'm mixing with my fork, with the fork. Okay, I think I am done. I'm going to taste it, make sure. Oh, it's good. It's delicious. I'm not going to put anything else. Going to leave cooking a little bit more, just so the flavors get combined a little bit more.
I think mine could use more sage.
Oh yeah, go for it. Because mine was very small, so I put like maybe 15 of them. Because mine is just small leaves, because I just took them from the garden.
Okay, so can you put it in now?
Yes. Yes. As long as you cook the sage, you know.
Okay.
So if you put it now and keep mixing, you're gonna end up cooking it, so you'll be fine.
I used to try to use fresh herbs, and it wouldn't work out, but it was like, I couldn't taste them, but I wasn't using enough.
Yeah. I just love the taste of fresh herbs. You gotta, once, I don't know how is your house, how much space you have, but I just have a pot, I have very, like, maybe five, 10 pots. I have maybe 10 pots outside, and I just plant like things like chives, spring onions, and sage. I have chocolate mint actually, which is a little, is awesome. I just have a little bit of different herbs, and then I things, because whenever you don't use, whenever you buy sage, you never use the whole package. Like right. Chives, I never use the whole package of chives. So whenever I use herbs that I don't use the whole package, usually I try to plant. But basil, whenever I use basil, I end up using pretty much the whole thing. So I don't.
Right.
I have basil outside just for fun, but I usually end up buying anyway.
I'm going to get a big pot and put all my different herbs in it. I bought some.
Oh, awesome.
So I got some like this, and I'm gonna plant them.
That's good. That's really good.
It's thrived out front, and they don't thrive in the back. I have to put them in the front yard.
And now is a very good time to plant them because spring's come. It's spring's already, so now is going to be a good time to plant them.
Yeah, we're still having a little bit of cold weather.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I think I am. Let me taste again, because if I, I'm afraid to overcook them. Mm. Mm. I'm gonna put a little bit more sage, like you, because mine end up tasting a lot of onion.
Mm-hmm.
You. Yeah, I'm gonna put some more sage as well. Okay, I am done. Now I'm excited to eat.
I'm looking for the cookbook. I don't know where to put it. I wanted to show you something. Here it is, right in front of me.
Oh, show me.
Okay. Okay, this recipe here, you see it?
Oh, give me a second. Let me just change it so I can see you. Oh, the pasta recipe?
Yes, yes. So most of the pastas, like rice pasta and things like that, I don't like. But I made it with this.
Oh, you wanted to know a pasta that you could use it?
Yeah, so I used this pasta, and it was really, really good.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. Yeah, I love this recipe, actually, because the tomato, the longer you leave the tomato in the salt, the juicier they become. So yeah. It's awesome. I love this salad.
Yeah, so it was, because I don't like, this is just red lentils, that's all that's in it.
Yeah.
And so it's the closest thing that I found that isn't, that is gluten-free, isn't a pasta, but yet it tastes like one.
That's good. That's good.
Delicious in this. I eat a lot of.
Yeah, it's hard to find a good gluten-free pasta. You just have to go around and just try to pick and find the one that works best for you. Because a lot of them, once you cook, they just break and just become, like, nothing.
Right, and I don't like rice or quinoa or none of those. They don't taste like pasta. So,
that's good.
But I found that one, I really like it. They have black bean. I don't like the black bean.
Oh, I like this one. Let me show you one that I actually like it. You might. This one. Can you see? So, this brand, they have one pasta that is made of mug bean. So it's a mug bean fettuccine. It's delicious. They have a black bean spaghetti, and this one is soya, soya bean. But they have like mug beans, and they have black beans. It's delicious. This pasta is my favorite. Like the mug bean fettuccine is my favorite. I love it.
So what is the brand name of that? Because I can't see it.
Explore Asian, I guess.
Okay.
This is
tiny international store in the town next to me.
Yeah, I usually buy them from Whole Foods. Sprouts has them as well, so you shouldn't be hard to find it.
Yeah, my closest Whole Foods is 3 hours.
Yeah, it's a bit hard to find it.
Yeah, I have to go to St. Louis or Nashville to go to Whole Foods.
Yeah. Sprouts, do you have Sprouts close by you?
No, we have Trader Joe's in Nashville or St. Louis. But Carbondale is only 250,000 people. It's very small.
Yeah.
It's really small. There's not much at all. I want to also you chocolate on here. You said some dark chocolate. What kind of chocolate do you buy? Like, what's the best brand?
For what?
It calls for in this recipe.
Which recipe?
On the one that we were making. It says some chocolate, dark chocolate, for the tart.
No. On the book?
Nope. On the email.
Oh, okay, I got it. So it's just dark chocolate. So what you're going to do is just going to melt dark chocolate whenever your pie is ready, whenever your tart's ready. So once you put your cream, you blend your cashews and everything, you're going to pour over your pie shell. And then you're just going to place some raspberry on top. And then you're going to melt some chocolate. And with the fork, you're just going to grab some chocolate with the fork and just drizzle on the top of your pie, on the top of your tart. So that's what you're going to do.
Okay. So then on this one, what I'm going to make next week, the brownie.
Oh, yeah. So this, I found this chocolate here. Wait, let me get it. I love this Belgium chocolate cocoa powder.
Does it have another name, or is it just called Belgium cocoa
powder? It's just Belgian cocoa powder. I usually use another brand, and they're good, but this one just makes the best desserts. Like, I'm using this one for all my desserts now, just making the best. It just makes stronger flavor of chocolate.
Oh, nice. Would you hold that up again, and I'll take a screenshot? Did you get that at Whole Foods?
I actually don't remember where I found it. That's going to be tricky to find it again.
Okay. Thank you, Austin. Nope, you're still there.
Okay. You got it?
Yes, I do.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah. So, all done.
Okay, so that's good. Is your spaghetti squash done?
Yep.
Okay, perfect.
So that's awesome. Thank you very much for doing this class with me, Andrea. I really appreciate you.
Oh, I really appreciate you.
That's so nice. I'm so happy that I got you to be more encouraged to cooking. You just made my night. Thank you for sharing this with me.
No problem. You have a wonderful evening, and I look forward to the next one. Maybe you're my daughter on that one.
Okay, let me know. Ask her which kind of curry or whatever she wants to learn, and I will do something for you guys.
Okay, perfect. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.